Today what we're going to do is back rescue for travelers, a quick 5-minute nice stretch that you can do to really take out those tight kinks that we have from traveling so much. So what we'd like to do first is come into child's pose, and Claudia's going to show you with big toe together, knees as wide as the mat, and then she's going to sink back towards her heels. And then I'm going to show you a modification. If you want to keep your knees together but not sink so low, you can actually reach the arms out in front. We're going to go for a nice stretch through the shoulders. You can place your forehead or chin down onto the mat. I'd like you to just practice 3 nice breaths. So you're going to do a deep inhale and exhale. Nice stretch right here, breathing into your lower back. Deep inhale and exhale. And last time, deep inhale and exhale. Then stretching further, I want you to come thumbs up and really move yourself to the back of the mat and really feel a nice stretch through the shoulders. And again, you can place your head down onto the forehead or onto your chin. From there, we're going to go into a nice twist. So take this arm, palm up, shoot it underneath that opposite arm and really feel this nice stretch through the top of the shoulder as well as the lower back. Take a breath in and exhale that out one more time. Take a deep breath in and exhale as you rise up, and we'll go to the other side. Shoot the opposite arm through, palm up, getting a nice twist, feeling it all the way up in the upper back here as well as into your lower back. Take a breath in and exhale that out. One more time, take a breath in, and then exhale as you rise up. So place your weight now onto your hands and your knees in this 4-point position, and we're going to come into a nice cat-cow stretch, really opening up that lower back. You're going to inhale, drop into a nice gentle arch, see how your back feels. Exhale like a cat, tuck your chin in, tuck your tailbone under. Repeat that, inhale. And exhale, 2 more times, deep inhale, and exhale, and last time, inhale, and exhale. Ah, that feels good, really opening up that lower back. Then we're going to walk the hands just a little further forward. We're going to come out to that universal yoga position called downward facing dog. Curl the toes under, and then as you slowly rise up, I want you to kind of walk your feet in. I want you to stretch through those toes as if you're heel toe walking, allowing that heel to drop down. Make sure as you're practicing this video with us that you are in your bare feet so that you can really get your feet to open. Good. Then as you take a deep inhale, as you exhale, I like you to think about pressing your chest back even further towards your toes. And you can always have a slight deep in if it feels like it's too tight. Down the backs of your legs. Take one more deep inhale. And as you exhale, take your tailbone down a little bit deeper towards your heels so you feel this full stretch every part of the body. Good. Then I'd like you to extend this right leg up as high as you can. Let that left heel drop. And we're going to swing this leg forward, coming into a nice hip stretch. Have your knee come across one side of the mat as the foot comes to the other. Good. Then I'm going to work this back leg back behind me. Some of you, your hip will come all the way down to the mat. Others, your hip might stay elevated, as what Claudia is showing you. You can put a towel or something that you have at home underneath that hip for support. Then you can stay lifted into the hands, or you can melt all the way forward, coming down and resting on your tub or mat as we open deeper into that hip. Good. Then from here, you're going to take another breath in. Curl that back toe under. We're going to come back through downward facing dog. Pressing again, melting the chest back even deeper, trying to keep those arms straight, and then taking your tailbone deep towards the heels. Good. This time the left leg is going to lift high towards the ceiling, and then you slide it forward, going into that hip stretch on the other side. And then again, you can place something under that hip, and then work your back leg back away. Take a breath in. You can either stay lifted or melt down all the way forward, allowing your body to completely let go. Good, and then finally, you can just press up and remove that. Swing the legs around to the front. The last thing we're going to show you is for if your upper back is tight, you feel like you've got a lot of areas in your upper back, I'd like you to take a towel at home or a mat, and we're going to have Claudia lay back, and it's going to go right between her shoulder blades. Her head and her arms can rest gently back, and this allows the chest to open, arms can be out to the side. You keep your bottom down on the mat and keep the knees bent to protect the lower back, and this will really help open up some of that tightness from sitting, perhaps on an airplane or in front of the computer for long periods of time. Good. We hope this helps you, and please try to practice this a couple times a week to rescue those tight back muscles. Thank you.